Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Münster. Right. Shalom to the wandered Israelites, which include Judah's children, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Indians, who are oppressed together, according to Jeremiah 50 and 33, but to whom pertained the adoption, the giving of the law, the promises, the glory, and the covenants, according to Romans chapter 9, opposed to the following teachings, which are, according to Revelation 14 and 4, represented the defilement, alright, by foreign women. May the kingdom of everlasting life and joy, the secrets be revealed unto you as a blood descendant of Jacob, whose name was later changed to Israel, Yahshua, in the Paleo-Hebrew tongue, scattered to the four winds of the earth, alright, as a people first. Okay, and what you see here is an angel, alright, of Yahweh, by Yahweh Shai, alright, and today we go a little bit into the topic, what one angel, alright, or actually angels, all together can do, man, alright, because we will we always bring that scripture out, Daniel 12, in that time Michael shall stand up, alright, the great prince which standeth for thy people, alright, in what time? In this time, Jacob's trouble, the end of Esau's world, alright, but not the end of the world itself, alright, okay, to bring back Israel to its righteous position, alright, as the rulers of this earth, alright, the one third, alright, and this is Isaiah 37 and 36, then the angel, okay, of Yahweh. So we will go into the topic of angels real quick, alright, went forth and smote in the camp of the Assyrians 185,000, alright, one angel, man, okay, and when they arose early in the morning, behold, they were all dead, corpses, alright, one angel, okay, 185,000. So what you think the Archangel Michael can do, okay? And this was, you know, basically, you know, this is heavy, man. Okay, Acts 12 and 23, that shows you the perfect timing also, man. Alright, and immediately the angel of the Lord, you see, smote him because he gave not Elohim, which means God in the Hebrew, the glory, and he was eaten of worms and gave up the ghost, alright? You see? Immediately, man, alright, these angels are around us, alright, you know, it's not the scriptures where we go to today that much, you know, but there are too much scriptures, man, too much, man, alright, on this topic, man, to bring everything out in this video, alright, you know, don't want to make it too long. He campeth around them that fear him, alright, these angels, okay, who have this power, alright. You can't see the wind, alright, but it's there, alright. And that same goes for the angels, man, and they even work with wind, man, alright. Spirit is like the wind, okay. 2 Samuel 24 and 16, alright. And these demons, alright, they are also spiritual beings, they see the angels, alright. And the angels see them, but we can see them as humans, alright. When we're gods, you know, maybe even Yahweh will give some brothers the spiritual power to see angels, man, alright? You know, to see demons and angels, man. It would be heavy, man, you know, it's just wonderful, man. Alright, we're wonderful, blessed, man, alright? Of course, we don't desire the day of the Lord, alright? There's no benefit in it. But, man, alright, this is a wonderful time to live in, man. And this is a wonderful inheritance what we have, man, alright? 2 Samuel 24 and 16. And when the angel stretched out his hand upon Jerusalem to destroy it, the Lord Yahweh repented him of the evil and said to the angel that destroyed the people, it is enough to stay now thine hand. And the angel of Yahweh in the Hebrew, which means Lord, was by the threshing place of Arauna, the Jebusite. Alright. Okay. There's also a scripture that talks about Israelites who actually Yahweh gave them the power for, you know, let's say like in half hour or some what it was, you know, that they could actually see spiritual beings, okay? They could actually see spiritual things happening, alright? So that power is real, and I believe some brothers will have that, alright? Okay? You know, some brothers will maybe, okay? It can happen, man. 2 Samuel 24 and 17. And David spake unto the Lord Yahweh when he saw the angel that smote the people and said, Lo, I have sinned. You see, so David saw the angel, man. Alright? So this is also scripture on it, alright? And I have done wickedly, but these sheep, what have they done? Let thine hand, I pray thee, be against me and against my father's house. Alright, you have angels, alright, appeared unto the priest, alright, because of the birth of, you would say, Johannes in German, alright, but it's, you know, the Nazarite, okay. First Chronicles, alright, so you have that often, man, alright, but, you know, when you see an angel fight, man, you are afraid, man, alright, you know, I also said in some video that David was afraid, you know, I have to do a correction also on that, because I don't, I believe I saw that in the text, alright, but, you know, I believe maybe it's not there, so this is a little correction, so there is not written that he was afraid of the angel. But as we can see here in 1 Chronicles 21 and 16, and lifted up his eyes and saw the angel, alright, of Yahweh, standing between the earth and the heaven, alright, having a torn sword in his hand, stretched out over Jerusalem. Then David and the elders of Israel, Yahshuala, who were clothed in sackcloth, fell upon their faces. Alright, so they fell upon their faces, man, alright, you know, the elders and David, man. Alright. Okay, if you see an angel, alright, you know, doing the work. Okay. Here's some pictures of angels. This is angel according to the Bible. Alright. So-called black man, so-called Negro. Alright. And wings are real, man, alright, wings are there, alright. You will read that about the cherubims, where we go into a little bit now. Also in this video, alright. Maybe they have even crowns on their head, man, we don't know, man, alright. Some details are not given, just, you know. This is another picture, alright. Here you have, again, wings, okay. So-called Negro man. Here you have Yahweh Shai with white hair, alright, hair like wool, alright, so that's a scriptural truth, alright, we go only by the scriptures, not by fantasy, okay, even fantasy, alright. This is the army of Satan fighting against the army of Yahweh. Why Yahweh Shai? You see a so-called UFO. Which are IFOs for us, alright, which means unidentified object, alright, so for us they are identified, and, you know, they want to play a little bit, you know, Yahweh gives them a little bit playground, alright, here on earth to fight against, you know, this is army of Satan here, you know, see this flying, they have many far better flying objects than this. Alright, you know, but you know, they can't stand a chance against the so-called UFOs, alright, you know, and don't think that, you know, this is Satan's army, and this is some kind of righteous army or something, alright, this is just Satan, the physical counterpart of Satan, which is Esau, fighting actually against his own creator, alright. By being deceived that he has actually a chance, and by being deceived that he is actually, you know, in some way, okay, some kind of power, alright, to actually do that without being completely destroyed immediately, alright? Euphis are the chariots of Alahayim. Real quick, Isaiah chapter 31, alright, as birds flying, they will the Lord of hosts defend Jerusalem. Zechariah chapter 5, then I turned, lifted up my eyes, and I looked, and behold, a flying roll. Alright, flying roll is not a flying roll, you know, why should a flying roll come into your window, man? Alright, shut the fuck up, alright? Go out of here, man, alright? Flying roll. 20 cubits. And the breadth of 10 cubits. Nigga, please, alright? Flying roll, This is a chariot, okay? Jeremiah chapter 4. Behold, he shall come as a clouds, and his chariot shall be as a whirlwind. Alright. Then here, 2 Kings chapter 2. And they even show you, alright, Esau is showing you these elites in the movies that these chariots will come to be my people. Alright. I just say, what is it? Not Nike. Alright. It's Foot Locker. Alright. Commercial from Foot Locker. And come to pass, as they still went on and talk, behold, there appeared a chariot of fire and horses of fire, and parted them asunder, and Elijah went up in a whirlwind into heaven into a chariot. Alright, and Elijah saw it, and he cried, my father, chariot of Yahshua, and the horsemen thereof, and I saw him no more. Okay, because this will eventually happen if you try to shoot at a so-called UFO. Alright, it will just disappear, and there is no, alright, hitting these objects, alright. Okay, Daniel 12 and 1, and at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince, which stand for the children of the people, and there shall be a time of trouble, such as never was since there was a nation, even to the same time, and at that time thy people shall be delivered, everyone that shall be found written in the book, the wondered elect, okay? Alright. So, basically, you know, it will be at one point, alright, where Esau don't even know where the lasers will come from, alright? So how you gonna fight, alright? But again, Yahweh will make it just like that, man, that you actually think you have a chance and that he can destroy you, okay? Again, you can't fight against spiritual powers, man. You can fight against spiritual powers, alright? But you will lose immediately, alright? You know, at a second he just can turn out the heartbeat of all these pilots, alright, or even when they're not controlled by pilots, alright, you see, when they are just machines, even flying objects in some cases, maybe even today, alright, and suddenly, alright, there's no power, alright, suddenly there's no pilot, alright, controlling this thing, alright, because of a lack of heartbeat, man. You know, this is really, unfair battle, alright. But Yahweh, again, is using deception also, alright? Okay, the deceiver and the deceived are his. I quote GMS Bread and Olive, alright? How these agents and Esau is actually thinking that they deceive somebody when the deceiver and the deceived are Yahweh's, okay? So they can't do nothing, they can't do shit, okay? But, you know, they are so deceived that they even think that they are not deceived, okay? So that's... just be mindful of that, okay? Michael, scripture is telling you, man, the deceiver and the deceived are his, man, okay? He is called Saint Michael, the Archangel, Saint Michael, alright? Who is like God, alright? This is the meaning of the name, who is like God, alright? If you go into the King James Version, you will have that meaning, alright? Who is like God? That is his name, man. Alright, who is like God, man? Alright. Who is like Michael, even, man? Alright. Who is like Michael? Alright. You know, as it goes for angels, man. Alright. He is the great prince, so to speak. Okay. Genesis 3 and 24. So he drove out the man, and he placed at the east of the Garden of Eden cherubims and a flaming sword, which turned every way to keep the way of the tree of life. Alright, so these cherubims are some kind of different angel, okay? And they were about to protect the garden, so, you know, nobody could go in there, alright? Alright, and this is, you know, also what we read about the cherubims. Song of the Tree, which is the Apocrypha, which is in the Bible for the wondered elect, alright, which is not in the Bible for the heathens. Blessed art thou that beholdest the deaths and sittest upon the cherubims. Alright, we will go into that word then. And to be praised and exalted above all forever. Amen. Alright, which means Amen in the Hebrew. And, you know, the holy language, alright. A cherub, alright. One who blesses, alright. A name of the, so it's one of the unearthly beings who directly attend to God Elohim, alright, in our faith, alright, in our truth, man. The numerous depictions selah, of cherubim assigned to them many different roles, such as protecting the entrance of the Garden of Eden, alright. And they are far too powerful, man. And before we go to Ezekiel 10, where he actually saw that these cherubims, man, okay? Okay, before that, we will check some about that, man. Okay, Ezekiel, you know what he saw, man? You know what he saw, man? This is heavy, man, okay? This is too heavy, actually, man, what he saw, man. And that's why we read that, man, Ecclesiasticus 49 and 8, it was Ezekiel who saw the glorious vision, alright, which was shoot him upon the chariot of the cherubims, man. Alright, so it was Ezekiel, man. You know what a heavy vision this is, man? You know, brothers, and I myself, you know, we have also visions, man. Okay, but this vision, man, on another level, man. Alright. Sheesh, man, okay. This is another level vision, man. Okay. You know, deep colors, deep art, man. Alright, Yahweh is the master of art, man. Alright, deep, you know, in his creation, we see how he basically thinks, man. How beautiful his ways to create things is, man. But that, man, whoa, you know. That is some kind of creation, man. What he showed there, man. Alright, he showed Ezekiel, man, what he got, man. Okay. He showed him what he got, man. Alright. Just say it like that, man. Okay. What are these treasures, man? Alright. What the elect will receive, man. What are these treasures? Alright. Too beautiful, man. No eyes heard, no eyes saw, man. This is it, you see. This is the point, man. Alright, because even that what Ezekiel saw here, man, is far not to compare with what actually will come. Okay, Isaiah 37 and 16. O Lord Yahweh of hosts, God of Yahshua, you see, not of the heathen, the dwellest between the cherubims, you see, cherubims, kawarab, in the paleo tongue, alright, the holy tongue, cherub, or imaginary figure. Alright, again, this is Yahweh's, basically, man, alright, and, you know, this can sound a little bit, you know, but basically, it's Yahweh's imaginary figures, man, alright, this is Yahweh's, okay, art, man, alright, what he's, showing you here, man, okay, this is heavy, man, okay. You know, you have these animals here on the planet, man. You have ourselves, man. Look our brain, how it works, man. Alright, we don't even use most of the parts of the brain, man. Okay, or what it actually can do. Alright, look, check our body, man. The body is more complicated than Esau could ever understand, even if he would be here a million years, man. Alright, you know, we are, you know, okay. Even if we live only like 100 years, you know, the average man, alright, but guess what, man, this is already too complicated to know how it works, basically, okay, but this is really, alright, another part to it, man, just say it like that, man, okay, cherubim, an angelic being, as guardians of Eden, as flanking Elohim's throne, you see, as flanking Elohim's throne, as an image from hovering over the Ark of the Covenant. We had these cherubims on the Ark of the Covenant facing each other. You know, the golden Ark of the Covenant as the chariot of Yahweh, alright, not Jehovah, of course. This is just an Edomite website here, so of course you have some things going off, you know. But okay, a cherub or imaginary figure, man. So he showed Ezekiel, man, alright, you know, how beautiful his creation can be, man, alright, because you have precious stones, alright, that, you know, that had a shine like it's not even real, man. Alright, you look at it and it don't, you know, it don't look real at it, you know, basically. Okay, that's how the kingdom will be, man. Alright, is this real? Alright, you know. Okay, is this real? Okay, it's heavy, man. Okay. Thou hast made heaven and earth. Alright, thou alone, even thou alone, of all the kingdoms of the earth, thou hast made heaven and earth, man. Thou art the power, or the powers, man. Alright? Okay. And Ezekiel is back, man. Maybe he's in the spirit world, but maybe he's back. Alright, but we don't know who he is, man. But he had that honor, basically, man. Psalms 99 and 1, the Lord Yahweh reigneth, let the people tremble, he sitteth between the cherubims, let the earth be moved, man. So these cherubims are really that heavy, because he is actually right with them, man. Alright, they are directly around him, as we just read, man. Okay, you know, you have things and beings that are not directly around or with him, okay? But these beings are directly Adam, man. Okay, and did you know, can you understand that, what he actually saw, man? Okay. Then I looked, and behold, in the firmament that was above the head of the cherubim, so this is Ezekiel's vision, okay, there appeared over them as it were a sapphire stone, as the appearance of the likeness of a throne. All right, not the sapphire stone what you can see right now here on earth, man. All right, you know, but the size, man, and the, you know, ah, man, you know, this is, it's very heavy, man. Okay, you know, just imagine how everything was basically shining, man. All right again, not what you see right now, okay, as the appearance, you know, a Z completely out of, you know, or just a rainbow appearance, you know, that look like basically gemstones, man. Alright, you know, a shining that comes through, alright, like gemstones, man, you know, a spiritual aura, man, or something like that, man. You can't even imagine how beautiful these colors are, actually, man. Alright, and how deep actually these stones can look, okay, as the appearance of the likeness of a throne. And he spake unto the man clothed with linen, or how you say it in English, and said, go in between the wheels, even under the cherub, and fill thine hand with coals of fire from between the cherubims, and scatter them over the city. And he went in my sight. Now the cherubims stood on the right side of the house when the man went in, and the cloud filled the inner court. And the glory of Yahweh went up from the cherub and stood over the threshold of the house, and the house was filled with the cloud, and the court was full of brightness of Yahweh's glory. Okay, so this is brightness, okay, what you can't see, okay, normally you can't see that. And the sound of the cherubim's wings was heard even to that, you know what it is, man, to you know, this is heavy, man. Okay, because you even, you know, your eye will basically fall out, man, if you look too long at the sun. But you understand how bright Yahweh and his works are, man? Alright, let's get it real quick. 10,000 times, what is it? Brighter than the sun, man. Alright. Brighter than the sun, okay. So you actually could not see it, King James Version, alright, if your spiritual eye is not open, you see? Because you really can see it with your eyes. Okay, that's the point. Okay, Ecclesiastes 23 and 19, such a man only feared the eyes of man. Again, the eyes of man will be destructed, okay? They will be finished, okay? Finished. Eyes of men are finished, okay? And no, not that the eyes of Yahweh are 10,000 times brighter than the sun, man. Again, your eyes will F up if you look even at the sun too long, man, okay? You know, because it's too bright, basically, man. But this is a white brightness, man, okay? And again, the stones, okay? Just imagine the stones in that brightness, man, you know? And the kingdom, basically, okay? But guess what? The same thing with Yahweh Shai. You can read that his face was white as snow, which means that his face was shining, okay? Okay? Because Esau is wet, and this means not that he is an Edomite or something, okay? Again, hair like wool, alright, and a face that was shining, okay? Of course it was shining, okay? So that's why you call it white. You know, for the elect out there, okay? Heathens will, of course, not understand things in some cases. And this is really also heavy, man. Verse 5. And the sound of the cherubim's wings was heard even to the outer court, man. As the voice of the Almighty God Allahayah when he speaketh. So again, he's about wings, man, okay? He's about wings, man, and his angels have wings, man, most likely, alright? You could hear the cherubim's wings, man, okay? Okay? You know, not like some bird wings out there, man. Some heavy, heavy sound, man, some bass, man, coming straight out of heaven, man, okay? Some bass... You know, in the action of the wings, actually, man, some bass over there, man. Okay. Again, that's Yahweh's, you know, imaginary beauty, man. Then the glory of the Lord went out of the cherub and stood over the threshold of the house, and the house was filled with cloud. Okay. And the sound of the cherubim's wings, man, was heard even to the outer court. Alright, and it came to pass that when he had commanded, the man clothed with linen, saying, take fire from between the wheels, from between the cherubims. Then he went in and stood beside the wheels. And one cherub stretched forth his hand from between the cherubims onto the fire that was between the cherubims. Alright, I once had a vision about the kingdom, alright, coming down from heaven. You know, it just looked like, described like a, you know, cube, alright, and I saw, it was actually only, you know, like 5 seconds or something, alright, or even more, I don't know, you know, sometimes it's actually even an hour, okay, but it was golden, and it was, really it was, it seems to be light years away, okay, it was looking like it's light years away, man. But it was, at the same time, it was extremely near, okay? So that's how Yahweh works, man, okay? I thought it was completely, you know, out of space, but the background was completely white. And this thing, this cube was coming down, and it turned, you know, at the same time when it was coming down, it turned a little bit. And I couldn't saw the city, but I saw that the inner cube would be the city, because the front was like a golden cover over it, so you couldn't see the city, but you know, alright, you knew that behind this cover, the city is actually in it, alright, so again, that's why we will have chariots that have a place, okay, or even a palace in a chariot, which in the outer appearance is actually not even more than 20 cubits, for example, alright? Okay? this is all spiritual and it's all for man, not possible. Okay, just say it like that. Just that you understand. But it was, you know, my first or even second vision what I had. Alright, and I deleted that video, I believe, also. You know, it's long ago. But really, you know, and therefore, okay, thereof, and put it onto the hands of him that was clothed with linen, and who took it and went out. And there appeared in the cherubims the form of a man's hand under their wings. And when I looked, behold, the four wheels by the cherubims, one wheel by one cherub, and another wheel by another cherub. And the appearance of the wheels was as the color of a beryl stone. You have many stones coming up here, you know, everywhere, basically, man. Alright? And I also saw the stones at the city. But I didn't know what stones there were, alright? You know, when I look in the scriptures, I know it. I believe I saw four, alright? But they were very, very big, man, okay? You know what one stone in that size would cost, man? It's not even possible to have a stone in that size, okay? That's how much it costs. Okay? When they went upon their four sides. They turned not as they went, but to the place whither they had looked. Okay, they followed it. They turned not as they went. Okay, and their whole body, and their backs, and their hands, and their wings, and the wheels were full of eyes wound about, even the wheels that they forehead. Okay, so again, man, this is an imaginary creation here. And it just looks how you would expect it to look, man. You know, Yahweh-like, man, okay? You know, with eyes all on their wings, man, okay? You know, this is heavy, man, okay? Beautiful, man, alright? How does a wing with eyes on look to you? Alright, I ask you, alright? I ask you again, how does that look to you? Does it not remind you of... basically Yahweh sees everything, alright, like his eyes are like wings, man, alright, you don't know, man, okay, we don't know, man, okay, Yahweh is, you know, he's the power of powers, man, okay, you know, give him all honor and praise, man, alright, you know, just as we read it with the one who gave not Yahweh the glory, man, you know, immediately an angel came up, man, and effed him up, man, okay? Ezekiel 10 and 14, alright? Zalachiah 13. As for the wheels, it was cried unto them in my hearing, O wheel. And every one had four faces. The first face was as the face of a cherub. You know, I can just, you know, feel in it, so that's why I'm a little bit stucking at some point, Zalachiah, okay? You know, I really don't want to stuck. It's not even the language so much, okay? Was of the face of a cherub, and the second face was the face of a man, and the third the face of a lion, and the fourth as the face of an eagle. Okay, so four faces, okay, and creatures, okay, and the cherubims were lifted up. This is the living creature that I saw by the river of Shebar. Okay, Shebar. Kebar, a river of Mesopotamia, okay, Chebar far off, you know, the river far off, basically, a Babylonian river near which many Israelite exiles settled, maybe the harbor of the royal canal of Nebuchadnezzar, Kebar, okay, in the Palaeolithic. 16, and when the cherubims went, the wheels went by them, and when the cherubims lifted up their wings to mount up from the earth, the same wheels also turned not from beside them, okay? When they stood, these stood, and when they were lifted up, these lifted up themselves also, for the spirit of the living creature was in them, okay? This is all how Yahweh works, man. Spirit, spirit, okay? Spirit, 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 okay? Spirit is power, man. Pure power, right? As the elder Manatasakwa said it, man. Pure power, man. A white spirit, man. You know, just spirit, okay? Ezekiel 10 and 18, and the glory of Lord Yahweh departed from of the trees hold in the, of the house and stood over the cherubims. And the cherubims lifted up their wings and mounted up from the earth in my sight. When they went out, the wheels also were beside them, and everyone stood at the door of the east gate of the Lord's house. And the glory of God Elohim of Yahshua was over them above. This is the living creature that I saw under the guard of Israel by the river of Sheba, the river of far off, basically. And I knew, you know, you have to be far off, man. Okay, again, man, this is, you understand how heavy that vision actually was, man. All right, this was not some random possible, it can look like that vision, all right? It was a direct vision of these these beings, okay, and these what it basically looks, man, okay, this was a direct vision, man, okay, how it all looks, man, how it all looks, okay, directly, okay. Not, you know, like possibly this, or you know, some brothers have this vision about spiritual power, it can look like that, but you don't even know, you know, how spiritual power will look and how it feels, but you know that you can do it at that moment, you know, and you know you have many different powers and so on, you know. Not that, man, okay, not that possible this and this, you know, but a direct, man, direct vision, man, okay, you know. This is how it looks, basically, okay? Everyone had four faces apiece, and every one four wings, and the likeness of the hands of a man was under their wings, okay? And the likeness of the faces was the same faces which I saw by the river of Sheba. Their appearances and themselves, they went everyone straight forward, alright? So again, this was a vision straightforward, man, okay? So we can read it today, man, alright? Okay, because our visions are of course also important, alright? We read it in the scriptures that there will be the time where he, guess what, man, alright? Where he puts the spirit, alright, on us to see these visions, okay? Of course, man. Alright, and they are also important, and they are also beautiful, alright, and also, what is it, necessary, man, okay, you know, but this, man, you know, and even if you go upon the lines, alright, you already can imagine what it looks like without, you know, pulling up here some pictures, you know. Even when Porters did some pictures about it, not just Esau and the other heathens, actually, even, alright, because they know the Bible, alright, and they also are very buzzy by, okay, putting heathen confusion out there, alright. You know, not just Esau, you know, it's not Esau every time. But, you know, you can just see it, man. If you check these verses, man, you can see it, man, okay. And with that, all praises, okay, because this was the last verses, okay, to Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai, Baal Shem, HaKadosh. Alright, I hope you received some edification and some meditation, you know, on that, man, okay. See? Alright, Shalom to the One Dirt Israelites, okay. And we see us in the next video, alright, hopefully.